So on this bit here, where we've run the catenary up to, we're going to be putting a scenic break across there. So we'll be changing from the winter scene into the town scene and the mainline station. So what we need to be doing next now is to get some battens secured on the two parts of the wall there. And we're going to be putting another scenic baseboard above the top of the mainline station area here. And the town scene is going to go on there. So it'll be sitting around about 4 inches above the tracks here to allow for clearance with the catenary and stuff. Once we've got that done, then we'll look at extending the catenary around and through the mainline station area there. So and what will be the winter canal scene here? You can now see we've now got the catenary on the inner mainline track here, and that we've added an extra piece on the baseboard here and here, and this is basically just to allow the correct clearance for the mass and the track. So, and as I say, across this point here we'll be adding like a frozen canal. So with the catenary, it now runs round to the small through station, which is Kilbrack station. We've also raised the height of the rail bridge as per the rail thing, so that now clears the catenary wires. We'll also be extending the scenic back scene along there as well. So I've seen, was it a winter back scene photo sheets, which we'll be putting on that side there. So with the road bridge, we'll be acting like the scenic break. With the station here, basically what I've got to do now is to extend the catenary through the station. Now it's either going to be a case of drilling holes in the platform and inserting the mast through there, or is to scratch build some girder spans and have the mast sat at the back side of the platform. The reason being for that is that at the moment Dayport don't do the Hirsch girder span that covers a 4-3 track main line. So it's either a case of scratch build, wait for Dayport, or source what else might be out there. So in this corner of the layout here, which is the Kilbrack Distribution Centre and the Engineering Workshop, one of the new additions that we've done to this part of the layout here is, if you look carefully here, you can see we've added a fire barrel, and this has got a wood, burnt wood fuel load in there, and I'll show you this in a bit. It actually works. It's got a flickering flame, and this is by RML Electronics, and basically you have a choice of either the burnt wood fuel load or a coal fuel load, and then you have a choice of two different coloured flickering flame effect lights, one being the orange and the other being red. So I say you'll see a little bit later on this video with this fire barrel working. And for those of you that might have missed it previously, in this corner here we have a burnt out brake van that was produced by one of the guys at my local model shop. If you're interested, PM me and I'll pass you the details for the shop and who to contact as regards for doing them. So moving back over to the Railport Logistics Container Depot, we have got to still add a back scene along the wall there, which I'm still in the process of getting sorted, so hopefully it shouldn't be too long before we get that sorted. We've also extended the Palisade fencing along the back here, where the two green containers are, and we'll be extending that along the back wall there, and that's a laser cut kit from modelrailwayscenery.com. Now the other thing that was mentioned in the previous update was that we were going to add some yard gantry lighting, And as you can see here, we've now got two installed. These are from RML Electronics and they are new for this winter. They contain a ring of six high quality high bright LEDs. It's a brass tube construction which widens out as it gets down to the bottom of the base. You need to drill a 6mm hole for these to fit into, and they run off was it 12 volts DC. Height wise you're looking around about 245 mm, so very pleased with them. I'm going to get another two, so I'm going to have one on the corner there by the end of the fence with the two containers, and we're going to fit another one round about in the middle of the yard there near the end of the orange safety barrier. The other thing we've got coming, shouldn't be too long now, is a gatehouse, which obviously we're going to be installing about where the back end of the trucks are there. So I'll put the links below for RML Electronics with the lighting, and for modelrowerscenery.com for with this forthcoming gatehouse kit and the fencing. One of the things I've shown previously, but for those of you who may not have seen them, again this isn't another product for RML Electronics, I'll show another one as well after this, is these buffer stops that they produce, and these are fitted with a working, it's a constant light LED, and again these run off a 12 volt supply. Now I've shown you this previously in one of the videos a few years ago, so I thought I'd show it again. This is another kit from RML, and this is basically the flashing tail light kit, as you can see here. We've installed one in the back of this Airfix Daypole Mark IID aircon coach. These you often see the toy and train fairs and swap meets and stuff. This coach is fairly easy to get into. It's basically a case of just unclipping and pulling off the door, and then the body all unclips off. The kit all comes supplied with the battery, the switch and everything you need. So basically what we've done, as you can see here, is that we've drilled two holes for the wires to feed through, and we've put the switch there, and just in case of two small holes for the flashing tail light there. I've had this kit in here now round about 5 years and it's still running on its original battery, as is this wagon here, which in one of my previous videos you actually see us where I demonstrate fitting this kit. With this one I basically just left it so the switch was accessible on the inside, so yeah, also getting the battery so you don't have to sort of take the body off. But say with the battery life, it lasts quite a long time. I mean, this is like 5 years and they've had a lot of use, yeah, and still going strong. So we'll just turn it on for you. Again, so if you have a look in the link below as to where to get this kit from.